Hi everyone. So this is the video I was talking about, the moon. The moon is the mother, the nourishing, like the love, the care, the nourishing energy. She is the queen of the royal family of India, you know. The Vedic astrology, they see all the planets as a family. Sun is the king, Mercury is the prince, Venus, she's the princess. So as I was saying before, the moon is the mother. So if I do something like this, I take one and I take two and I put it in here. Moon is the mother. She's the one who gives milk. It is why the color white is related to the moon and to the mother, because the milk is white. And the mother, she's nourishing. Who she is nourishing? The kids, the newborn baby. But she's also nourishing everyone in the family. Mother loves to live in the kitchen. She cooks for everyone. She wants everyone to be happy. Bam! I'm back without snow. Why? What happened? Something happened. My iPhone just froze the other day with the snow, with the wind, the 0 degrees. So I came back after 3 days. Now, as you can see, there is no more snow. Everything is gone. I'm exactly in the same place. And I want to keep on going through the meaning of the moon. So because the moon is related to the mind gets all the diseases related to the mental illness, like schizophrenia, or bipolarity, or Alzheimer, or phobias, also any kind of phobia, fear, unknown fears. Of course, you have to see the placement of the moon. Maybe the moon is placed with Rahu, the moon is placed with Saturn. Saturn is giving a lot of fears and sudden changes. We wake up every morning with, and we're going to sleep with. It's related to sleep, the rest, the bed, insomnias, all the places related to sleeping, like hotels, guest house, Airbnb places you go. This is related to the moon, because it's the place of sleeping and resting. In Ayurveda, moon is related to Vata, movement, the air movement. So it is why the mind is like the clouds in the sky. The thoughts are passing and going and coming. Sometimes there is disturbance, there is a lot of wind in our mind, a lot of confusion, stress, inability to focus, lack of concentration. Wow, there is a beautiful dog in there. I want to show it to you.
Ciao.
You saw the dog? Wow, so beautiful. People come here and walk in nature. I'm running almost every day in here to, you know, to make space in my mind. The thoughts are coming. The full moon is very important. The new moon is very important. Why? Because there are periods of time in astrology that, you know, when there is the full moon, things happen, emotion are increasing and decreasing a lot. You can go into a state of depression, state of higher excitement also. There is an airplane in here right now, it's so noisy. Some mental imbalance during the full moon, because emotions are so high. New moon emotion can be so down, like the shadow going to retrieve, go to the cave and meditate. Moon is related to menstrual cycle. The woman go through a period of cleansiness, losing blood. The man, they don't know too much about this. It's good if you are in a couple, if you are a woman, speak with your boyfriend, your husband, just to let them know what happened to you and why you need silence, why you need some isolation, why you need care, why you need hugs, also why you need to be close to the woman in that moment as a man. because for women, as I understood, with relationship with the feminine, because moon is the feminine, is the Shakti energy, we as a man, we don't understand very well what is happening. So let's share knowledge, experience, your own experience with the menstrual cycle, and just share it with your partner. Moon is everything also related to water, like the lakes, the shore of the the sea is related to the moon. The rain, the snow, like the other day. Water are emotions, and in Vedic astrology we see the moon related to emotions and the mind and the desires. And this is very tricky. So let's check how many desires and how deep and how profound and how often you have desires, because then the desires did completely create an imbalance within our emotion and our mind, because too much desires, one desires bring to another desire brings to another desires, and this the Tibetans, they speak very clearly about this, is the more desire you have, the more than you have to balance and understand what happened to you. It is why they say try to renounce to as much desire as you have if you want to have peace of mind, because the desire they create emotions, and emotion then comes to the mind, and they are disturbing the peace. So places like very windy, like today, I think you can hear the wind, like Canarian Island in Spain, or some other places in the world where it's so much windy, people go a little bit, not mad, but they get a little bit confused, disturbing the peace of mind, the sleep. Because the element of wind is related to the moon, because the moon is constantly doing the 28 days movement cycle related to the menstrual cycle. And without the moon, there would be no life on Earth, because the moon is barometer of instinct, sexual instinct in animals' kingdom. And in humans, the moon is what regulates the menstrual cycle. So remove the moon, there is no life on planet Earth. It's very important. Remove the sun, there is no life on planet Earth. Remove Jupiter, there is. It is why we cannot not see the sky, because these planets are here for something, and they teach us something. And there is another person in here, is the one, maybe I ask him to go and check if they have cow. So moon become one of the most important planet of Vedic astrology with Mercury, because Mercury is also the way we interpret the daily life, you know, it's our discrimination, our intelligence. So we cannot say that one planet is more important than the other one. Mercury is super important also. And then you have the sun. Of course, the sun is related to your ego, your personality, your character, your identification, and you cannot avoid to have a personality. So see the importance of all these planets. So to go back to the white, yes, moon is giving milk, and milk in India is very important. Why? Because they use it in Ayurveda. They do this decoction, they purify the milk to obtain the ghee, and the ghee in Ayurveda is a high medicine. You can do a lot of treatments related to ghee. You can even put ghee in the eyes, and internally you can use ghee. And for cooking in India, in Ayurveda, they use ghee. They don't want toxins, and they want the food cooked easily without heaviness of fat, especially. So the milk is important because it's related to the cow, and the cow, I wish I can meet a cow in here somewhere. So thank you to the mothers, because finally the mother India, as we call it, wants to give knowledge, wants to give remedies. Mother India gave Ayurveda, yoga, pranayamas, tantra, gave knowledge of singing mantras. India is like Amma Amma in Kerala, in south of India, the woman who's hugging. Why she's hugging so many people? What is the relationship, the mother, the moon, a person who is daily talking about love and daily wanting to hug people? The guy is going to take me to this place in here with the cow, so he's the owner. I'm going to go with his wife. So I'm approaching. Bonjour, bonjour. Vous nous faites visiter les vaches? Allez, super. So we are here with the big cows in here, and this is what gives the full milk. This is just amazing. Amazing opportunity to be here. Hello. And this is the full nature of Switzerland. So this is another one of these big, beautiful houses. This full